Hello everyone, I'm Răzvan and in today's tutorial I'm gonna show you how you can create a landing page using Figma. Right from the beginning, I want to warn you that this is not a step-by-step tutorial but rather more like a time-lapse where I will explain and break down the section of the page and tell you what I've created and why. Let's start with an overview of the page we're gonna build. Basically, it's a landing page of a website whose main purpose is to promote attractions across London and other cities in the UK. I've started by creating the very first section of our page, which is the header, where we have the navigation and the logo. The navigation will help users get tickets, find out nice things to do, accommodation, and information for those who are coming from outside of UK. Right after, we have the main call to action. This is the most important area of the page because it's the section where we are telling our visitors what to do and what to expect from the website. After, we have the possibility to search by location or some keyword. This feature comes in handy if you don't want to waste time searching for something on the website. Instead, all you have to do is type here and the results will appear. Down below, we have this nice looking illustration with all of the iconic buildings from London. Because this page is all about visiting London, we needed something related to that. Next comes the featured attraction section, where we are promoting the best location out there. Let's say that the owners of that business paid us to gain more exposure to our website. Well, this will be the section where this is gonna happen. We have an image of the attraction, some info about it, a button for booking a trip, and that's it. To achieve the same result as me, just simply duplicate the image you're gonna use, apply the layer blur effect, and then adjust the value of blur accordingly. After this, we have the top 10 attractions. This section is very useful, especially if you haven't decided what to visit yet or you simply don't know any attraction in London. This section will help you decide what to visit. I created like a carousel using these cards with the possibility to browse by holding the mouse pointer either to the right or to the left of the page. The big card represents the animation for when you hover over attraction card. So all of the content above is related to attractions from city itself. This section promotes attractions from outside of London with the possibility to view them by clicking the See All button. It's very important to name your layers and groups properly because this will help you navigate more easily through them. And this is what I'm doing right now. At the very end, of course, we have the newsletter area where people can type in their email address to receive further information from us, like offers for tickets or every time when a new attraction is added to the website. As a tip for you, before even starting to design something, just sketch some rough ideas on paper, as many as possible, and then go to your design software and start creating some low fidelity wireframes. After that, if everyone validates a version, go with it and create some design proposals. If you are lacking inspiration, you may want to check out some websites like Dribbble or Behance. On these websites, you will find plenty of beautiful designs to inspire you. In the end, we have the footer, which contains some basic information like about us, legal stuff such as terms and conditions, and so on. That's it guys for today, hope you like it, and if you have any specific questions or requests for new tutorial, just use the comment section below. Bye!